In the good old times, people learned how to read and to write. That's no longer sufficient in the high-tech 21st century. We also need to know how to deal with risk and uncertainty. And that is what I mean with risk savvy. Here's a simple example. You hear on the weather report that there's a 30% chance of rain tomorrow. 30% chance of what? Now, I live in Berlin, and most Berliners believe that it means that it will rain in 30% of the time, that is 7 to 8 hours. Others think it will rain in 30% of the region. Most New Yorkers believe that's all nonsense. It means it will rain on 30% of the days for which this prediction has been made. That is, most likely, not at all. Many psychologists think that people can't learn how to deal with risk. But in this case, it's the experts, the meteorologists, who have not learned how to communicate risk in an understandable way, that is to say, to what class the 30% refers, time or region or days. And if you have some imagination, you can think about other classes. For instance, one woman in New York said, I know what 30% means. Three meteorologists think it rains and seven not. Now, getting soaked is a minor risk. But are we risk savvy when it comes to more important things? For instance, 20-year-olds drive with their cell phone glued to their ears, not realizing that they decrease the reaction time to that of a 70-year-old. Or many Americans, about 20%, believe that they are in the top 1% income group, and as many believe they will soon be there. Or take health. So about an estimated 1 million children get every year unnecessary computer tomography, CT scans. Unnecessary because they're not really clinically indicated, which is not just a waste of time, but also danger to the kids, because a CT scan can have the radiation of 100 chest x-rays and may lead in a small number of these kids later to cancer. We deal every day with risks, but we haven't learned how to understand them. And the problem is not simple in the human mind, but also in experts who either don't know what the risks are or don't know how to communicate them, or in other areas, like if it's about finance or health, have interests other than yours. So the key message is this: everyone can learn to deal with risks. In that case, everyone can learn to ask the question, probability of what? And second, if you believe that you're safe by delegating the responsibility of your wealth and health to experts, then you may be disappointed, because many experts do not know how to communicate probabilities or try to protect themselves against you, as in healthcare, as a potential plaintiff. So you have to think yourself. And that's the key message.